Hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to Disgaea PC. What? He's bragging about having an important hint for you. What? What? Alright, missed that one. Wait. Please select where you'd like to go. Somebody has a hint for me and I was not paying attention. You know what? Let's quit back out. Yeah, I forgot. I didn't actually, at least loading in is really fast. Okay. Talk to the zombie over there who's bragging about having an important hint for you. Okay, there we go. Today I'm going to give you a pretty straightforward hint. Go to the lunar snowfield. The printies are there. You know, I don't think you can call that a hint. Okay, well, we're going to lunar snowfield. Why did we even have to talk to the zombie? Okay, this place looks like it sucks. Yeah, this place super sucks. Huh. Like, if I could do the old person tower that I could in Disgaea 5, this would work perfectly. But it doesn't work. I mean, we could try just winning. Unfortunately, these guys are actually nearing my level. Okay, let's go at it with guts, this direction. Because it has the least number of enemies to work with. And when guts don't work, I don't know what I'll do. Okay, Flonne. Music here is really good. Let me guess. Ice? Ice? Really? Not all of them are ice, though. Damn. So two are fully resistant to ice, two are fully weak to ice. Wind, 0, 0, 50. Okay. Looks like we're doing wind on this one. I can't do wind. Okay, well, let's just do ice. Call it a day. Okay. Yeah, this is gonna be a really rough fight. I out-level them, but only by a little bit. Enemy boost 3 is generally not something I want to, like, tango with if I can avoid it. But today, we got no choice. Okay, which ones are... You're weak to ice, you're weak to ice, you're strong, you're strong. Okay. So we pretty much have, like, zero success rate one way or another on these. You know what? I'm gonna send Medeiros out here. Medeiros, you're cool and all, but you're useless to me. So yeah, if I can wipe out this entire side... Yeah, we got this. Okay. They got the boost, but they're not invulnerable. They're just very tough. Oh man. This means Etna doesn't get to do anything. Alright, whatever. At least we know we can succeed at this one. So yeah, we'll just break through and, ow. We'll just break through and deal with it, I guess, or something. I'm not really sure on that. Okay, Wind Cutter. So, she takes Flonne's spot. Flonne, move here. You move here. We're gonna do Wind Cutter. We're gonna do... Will this work? So what I'd like to do is chuck Laharl to the opposite side. Okay, cool. So we'll have Flonne do a heal. Do we deal with heal or do we just... Nah, let's do a heal. just in case I can somehow manage to save Moe's swords here. I'll probably send out the Prinnies to keep distracting the enemies where I can. I need to get her mega heal at some point, so we actually heal more than just 165. Okay! Dandelion! Yagurn. Grand Slam Man. That should be enough. Okay. Yeah, note to self, hire some more bait here. Yeah, so there goes more swords. Okay, come on, Laharl. Does not have the movement speed on this. Alright, whatever. So Etna's gonna go down. Pretty much no choice on that one. Prinny, go back. Etna, if you're gonna go down, you might as well take this guy with you. We'll make it! Still sucked. See, this is why the old man tower was awesome. But completely not the game. They must have added that by, like, Disgaea 3 or 4 or something like that. But you could effectively... I'm gonna have to break it, too. Or not. I'm gonna treat this as super Laharl grind time, I guess. Or eventually super Flonne. Why did I call her Flan? I don't know. Super Flonne grind time. We'll see who lives through this one. So let's bring Flonne out, seeing as she's taking like zero damage. Okay, they're all bunched up for me too. In retrospect, this is probably a bad move, but we'll do it. Whatever. She'll probably live through this. They don't have enemy boost anymore. So let's see. Yep, they come back for her. They do damage to her. So what we want to do is roll her back out of the reduced damage zone. And we'll just heal her. She'll probably live through this. Okay, Laharl on the other hand... can't really do much here. I guess he'll just make his way and fight or something. This is a mean level. These are mean enemies. Okay, so this guy's weak to wind. What's this guy weak to? Not wind. Ice? Ice. Okay, ice, ice, baby. That always works. So we're gonna do ice. They're gonna work. Oh, they're actually... in this configuration. Okay. Okay, let's move her out. We don't have a whole lot of... we don't have a whole lot of backups here. They've mostly died. But, you know, I got one or two. We got the Prinnies. They're... quite... weak. Well, whatever. It looks like they are completely entranced by the fact that I have a Prinny. Alright! I'ma use and abuse that. Continuously. Still not enough to kill him. Damn. Alright. Well, whatever. And note to self, raise some levels and do some grinding between... now and the future. Oh. Yes. Okay, I thought for a second Laharl had a new move, and I'm like, wait, no, never mind. This is patently false. Oi. I think I'm gonna have Flonne and Laharl. Reconvene or something. Ow, 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 ow. Okay, let's bring her back for a second. If I can get them all bunched up with a sneak attack, that'd probably be the easiest. This is a mean mission. Yeah. Okay. So Laharl will win this one. I seriously might consider actually respeccing him to use swords or axes or something. Yeah, she might be able to kill these guys off. Alright, Flonne, I believe in you. Murder death machine, go! At the very least, she'll be able to injure them enough that it shouldn't be a problem. Okay. Alternatively... Hogmiser! Bait! Laharl. Can't move. Okay, well... Hopefully they take the bait. They've taken the bait! Flonne lives to see another day. Hogmiser does not die. What the hell, Hogmiser? How'd you not die? You're level 12. I don't get it. This is not a nice mission. Yeah, we might actually... We absolutely will have to do some, like, legit grinding here. If this is gonna be the case. Well, I mean, I guess it's... kind of... a necessity after a certain point anyway. A little floored at the difficulty scale between Disgaea's 1 and 5. Maybe I did a lot more grinding in Disgaea 5, though, and it just never really clicked with me. I guess I did. The game went by a hell of a lot faster, so it made the concept of grinding, you know, a lot more enjoyable, because you could just more or less auto through things. I almost cast ice on the entire party out of, like, just on autopilot. That would have been dumb. Okay, yeah, so after this, we'll do some promotion exams and go set up the invincibility field. That guy is, Oh yeah, probably should have brought Flonne along. That guy is not moving. But yeah, setting up the invincibility field, plus raising the base enemy level to... what was it? 33. So, I think we have to raise the... enemy levels twice? I think that's how it works. I don't know. As a Dark Assembly type bill. If we do that, apparently if we get them up to 99, they give as much experience as a level 300 character. I'm gonna have to look into... Are you... He's supposed to be weak to fire! What? Oh, I see. His defense sucks. Apparently his AI sucks too. He is completely out of it. Alright. Well, there we go. So let's save for the sake of... I hate getting stuck on things. Let's heal. I'll try another level, but I think between episodes I'll definitely do the grinding thing just to get ahead in life. Because I don't want to deal with losing missions. Those are annoying.
You really don't know anything about the Prinnies? You've been acting weird ever since this morning.
I don't know anything. And even if I did, I wouldn't tell you!
What?
Prince Laharl, I have a name and it's Flonne! It's not Hey or you! You have never called me by my name, not even once, since the first time we met!
So, what's it to you?
People's feelings are delicate. They can be hurt by just the slightest insult. Laharl, you are too inconsiderate. You should approach people with more love. The Prinnies ran away because you have no love.
What? You stupid love freak! Who do you think I...
There. That's the attitude I'm talking about. Become a respected overlord with an attitude like that.
Flonne, that doesn't seem like the kind of advice an angel should be giving.
Ugh, what do you know about being an overlord? Forget it, I'm not talking to you anymore.
Okay, this level does not look nearly as dickish. It just looks messy. Wait. What? What? Why are these guys 2, 4? That's weird. 32, 8, 4. Why is this? What? Excuse me if I don't get the meaning here, but 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. Oh shoot, what is it? It's called like base 2 or something like that. Why they're in base 2, I could not tell you. Fascinating. Alright, you know what, in this case. We might as well get past it the fast way. Let's see, where's the furthest you can walk? Perfect. Okay, that did not work as well as I thought it would. I mean, it kind of injured them a little bit. But, well, this is just kind of sad. I probably should just let them come to me, and then we'll progress past this point. But, Stomp-O-Rama. For a second, I thought it said Stupid-O-Rama, and I got very confused there. Okay. Seeing as we're about to lose another Prinny here, let's not do it with Flonne. Just throw it with most swords. Oh, it's based on current health. Of course. I had forgotten that one. I guess maybe I shouldn't have used most swords then. Oh well. Let's do Overlord's Wrath. Take you out. We'll do Flonne. I don't even know what specific element these guys are weak to. The answer looks to be ice. I don't even know if this is really worth it, but still. Okay. Yeah, the last level was kind of rough. This one's just... the last one was kind of tough. This one feels like an inside joke that the programmers or the designers decided to put through. And I honestly can't tell you, like, what they're going... four on this one. I also do not remember this stage at all. I must have just thought of it as like a kind of weird joke, and that was the extent of it. I mean, I guess it is just a weird joke. Maybe the answer's in their name, too? Probably not. Okay. Well, whatever. I've got a very small amount of risk here. Mostly from that one guy. Okay. I'm just gonna keep doing Overlord's Wrath. It's worth training up anyway. We might as well do... No. You need the experience the most, even though... What I'm probably gonna do is do the cheesy grind trick, just because. It seems like every chapter enemy levels go up by about four or five... Maybe even 6. But that's enough for things to very quickly become surprisingly unmanageable. In terms of, like, leveling and whatnot. So yeah, what we'll do is just... wait for those guys to come, actually. I guess I could have healed, but whatever. I don't want to deal with, I don't want to deal with getting my ass handed to me. On a daily basis. Like, I like a challenge, but when it's enough of one that I'm like, I'm not sure if I can win this. Every single mission, and it takes forever. It's like, because I will be totally frank here. My goal of this series is mostly to get through it. Like I can totally respect this game for being, you know, a piece of history, Nippon Ichi history. But at the same time, I've already seen the entire plot. I more or less know how everything goes. I mean, there are definitely stages that I've forgotten. But it's not like super new or like I want to see how it goes anymore, and that kind of sucks actually. But it's life. That's what happens. It's video games. But the main thing is I want to get through this as fast as possible so I can get to Etna mode, because I actually haven't played Etna mode yet, and I'm kind of intrigued to see how that one's gonna go. I have no idea how unique this story is for Etna mode. And technically, I could have actually started in Etna mode if I really wanted to. But, I mean, where's the fun in that? Okay. So we'll either kill this one or... Where's Windcutter? It'll hit two of them. Let's just hit two of them. And I can just have Flonne come in for the finishing blow. Which I guess really is the least efficient thing to do, but whatever. Probably should have used Wind, but also whatever. But yeah, so I want to get to Etna mode just because I want to see how the plot pulls out differently. And if you don't know about Etna mode, I assume you're in for a treat. I have no idea if it's any good or not. So let's just... go overboard on killing this one guy. I can't even imagine this is a particularly tough one. Watch this be the level 1 stump critter. I have no idea. It died. That's all that we needed. That was it. Freezing souls. Okay, well, let's stop by the hospital. We didn't take too much damage, but still, it's a good plan. Alright, Lunar Snowfield, Freezing Souls. Let's see... story?
Etna? Why is Laharl so stubborn?
Huh? You kidding? He's always been like that.
I don't think that's entirely true. Haven't you noticed? His emotions are slowly changing. I thought that he'd finally awoken to the power of love.
Oh, so that's why you were so angry.
Yes.
That's a demon for ya. You seem to have your hopes pretty high, but don't you think that asking for love from a demon is a bit ridiculous?
You think so?
Well, the prince's case is a bit unique.
Unique?
Yep. You see, his mother, the queen, was an eccentric person. She was always talking about love and kindness.
That's not weird at all.
Well, I didn't hate her, but I guess she couldn't help it being a human and all.
A human?
Yep, she was a witch who came here to study. The king fell in love with her at first sight, and eventually, the prince was born.
Hmm, is that so?
She was always saying things like, "Demons can love too." Whenever the prince did something bad, she would scold him because she wanted to raise him to be a kind boy. Maybe you remind him of his mother, Flonne.
If he was raised that way, why is he like this now?
The queen died.
Huh?
A long time ago, the prince was infected with a rare disease that even the king couldn't cure. There was only one way to save him.
Which was...
the life of one who loved him.
Then?
That's right. The queen took her own life, despite the king's efforts to stop her. It was at that point that the prince started to hate love and kindness.
How sad. So unless his hatred fades, Laharl will have to live the rest of his life without love. Oh, that's just not fair.
Maybe so. But, I don't think that he's intentionally trying to hate love. Hatred isn't something that just disappears that easily, is it? Maybe you were a bit rough on him today. Well, don't try to get me involved.
Alright, any kind of weird tricks for this? Oh. Wow, this place kind of looks like it sucks. Kinda. Alright, this is going to take a lot longer than I thought it was going to. Alright, so what we're gonna do, I'm just gonna stack Laharl, Etna, no swords, can't stack her anywhere else, and Flonne. mean, they're the only functional characters that I even have right now. Which is part of it. Okay. I figured I'd lure him out. Ow. That hurts. Okay, let's do Skull Splitter. I want to save a little bit here. Triple Strike. Because, yeah, he can't fit anything else. Heal and Blade Rush. She's finally getting enough SP that she can actually use her skills. Oh, shoot. Blade Rush was a waste. Because Triple Strike. Damn it. Alright, whatever. Not the end of the world. Well, this is going to be a long mission. We'll probably be fine just because we have healing and whatnot, but still. Sky Launch. I don't think I remember that one. Okay, so yeah, let's keep healing. Let's keep working on killing these guys. So why don't we do that? Why don't we do Boulder Crush? Do I do Hurricane Slash? Nah, I can just attack him. And worst comes to worst, I have Laharl come in for the finishing blow. Unfortunately, yeah, okay, good. Unfortunately, swords do not have the, I don't know, they don't have the damage. They're not cheap, and most swords specifically does not have a whole lot of SP here to use. Which kind of sucks. Okay, now we can do Hurricane Slash. Seems like a good time for it. Colossal Fissure. And Laharl doesn't have anything special he can do here. So instead, could use Overlord's Wrath, but that seems really, really wasteful here. Okay, what are these guys? Looks like it's fire. Might as well kill them instead of working on healing right now. We haven't taken too much damage. Though, I really do need to boost my healing ability. In Disgaea 5, like, you really could just heal somebody back up to full in, like, one or two turns. This one, not so much so. But then again, we're using really inferior heals. So go figure that's gonna happen too. Okay. So we got three people still advancing. And these in the back are just kind of hanging out. What I'll probably do is actually just have Flonne nuke him from a distance. We'll play the ultra-safe method here. Okay, Tiger Charge. Hurricane Slash. We might end up pissing some extra guys off here, but I think we'll be okay. But yeah, these enemies have scaled up a lot more. Like, I thought by doing the cheesy, grindy, invincible trick, we'd be set for quite a while, but yeah. Unless you actually start, like, redoing missions, you quickly get outpaced by enemy levels in this game. I honestly can't tell you how I progressed through it the first time around. It's been so long since I've played Disgaea, like, Afternoon of Darkness on PC. So the concept of, like, how I managed to grind through all of this was... she didn't go down. Okay, good. Laharl, please tell me you can reach him. Perfect. Okay, so what we're gonna do is Overlord's Wrath. We're gonna get her out of there. Line these three up. That's not even remotely close to correct. Okay. Heal, line this direction. There we go. Okay. So this'll hurt them fairly bad? How bad? Not bad enough. Not bad enough, but still. Enough that most swords and Etna can finish them off the rest of the way. Okay. Yeah, we got this one. The one problem with my setup is, yeah, we are gaining levels a little bit faster. But, just because, you know, we're keeping it down to such a small team. The unfortunate side effect is we have like zero backup, so if anything goes wrong, we're pretty much shafted. What I might do is actually have like one hyper powerful backup character. That's what Grand Slam Man was back in D5. And that worked really well. So it's like if everything is going wrong, it can, you know, whip this character out and use him as a consistent teammate, team member to just roll people. Not so much today. Alright, whatever. Let's see, special. Wind Cutter. So we can Wind Cutter that one dude. Or we can do Overlord's Wrath. Okay, let's just go stand here. Probably gets them to come out. There we go. Okay, so their positioning is a little bit on the inconvenient side of things. I can try and do Lion's Roar. I don't know if it's going to hit them both. No time like the present. Okay, Laharl hasn't taken too much damage here, but we can worry about it a little bit. Ice. What are these guys weak to? Wind on both accounts. Which sucks because I'm only going to be able to hit one of them with it. Oh well. Let's hit the guy up high. Okay. So this should work out great. I'm trying to think. What else is there? Yeah, I guess after Edna mode for this game, I'm probably going to... I don't know. I don't know how long this game's gonna take, especially Etna mode. Like, I don't know how long that campaign is. But what I might end up doing along the way is, well, I've already mentioned that I'm going to be picking up a PlayStation TV. Actually, you know what? Let's just, we'll lift it and throw it. It's gonna take too long to break otherwise. But I'm probably going to be getting a PlayStation TV and the Vita games at some point. Unfortunately, buying them all individually is going to suck a bit. Because I don't think you can get the triple pack? I actually don't know. But I'll probably pick up the Vita versions of Disgaea 3 and 4. And probably D2? Yeah. Yeah, unless they suddenly announce that Disgaea 3 HD is coming out for, Disgaea 3 HD or something like that is coming out for PS4, or not PS4, especially for PC, then I'll change things around. But chances are, by the time I'm done with this game, I'm probably going to, I'm probably going to be ready to do another Disgaea game. I'd probably just continue with D2, just because story continuity is important. Oh, did they run out of SP? Is that why they're not buffing each other anymore? Because if so, that's hilarious. They did. That is goofy. I love it. Okay. But yeah, I'll probably play Disgaea D2 next. I don't know. It seems a little dumb for me to be planning ahead this much. Because I got like three other... Oh, she had just enough for a magic boost. Huzzah! You have succeeded, young wizard caster. Okay, so this is a little silly. If I could get to the side of them. Oh, target height problem. Okay. Yeah, that seems reasonable enough. And then we can have Flonne come in for just about equal amounts of carnage. Let's see. Actually, let's have Etna move back. So we could throw most swords up here. Let's not do that, though. I have no idea how rough those archers are going to be. Okay, special. Could do holy arrows. Let's not do holy arrows. We might want to do it anyway. I don't know what these guys are weak to. Looks like the answer is wind. Okay. Let's see if we can take out the entire group. Between Flonne and Laharl, should do enough damage to take them all out. They also have reduced attack power, so they're not going to be particularly tough. In fact, they're incredibly weak. Awesome. Okay, that makes this easier. And you can move. Oh, she'd already tossed, but she could still move. Okay, well, that was majestic. Could not have done that any better myself. So let's have her focus on that. Might as well just do... Can't do another Overlord's Wrath, but we can always do Blazing Knuckle. Okay. And assuming that one of them is still living. Yep, looks like wind is the go-to. Here we go. I don't know. I have this, like, bad habit whenever I'm playing Let's Play games to start thinking about, like, what am I gonna do next? Especially, like, during the slower parts. You know, the parts where I'm not, like, thinking too hard about things. Oh, shit. That one actually has quite the defense on him. Her, I guess. And so, like, oh, what was it? I was playing Xenoblade Chronicles X, and during, like, some of the slower grindy points, I was like, man, I just really want to go play Xenoblade Chronicles, and I'm like, yeah, you know, after this, I'll play Xenoblade Chronicles. And then, like, three other games came out, Digimon, and it's just like, never mind. We'll leave that one for later, honestly. Still not dead yet. Alright, fine. Flonne, you get the kill. Even if you're my most powerful character in terms of level. The convenience factor is just that important. Okay. That's it. I think we've got one more, but this is a great stopping point for me. So, I will see you guys in the next episode of Disgaea PC Afternoon of Darkness. And as always, thanks for watching.